In this section, we introduce the international distributions of our target species and the major studies that have been made on them. Nine papilio species occur in our research area. In this presentation, we separate these species into four groups based on the color pattern of their wings. The geographic distributions of these species in India region has previously been studied by Kaonka and Larsen, and these distributions are shown in this table. All nine papilio species occur in and around the Western Ghats Mountains. Now we will show you the international distributions of these species. These maps have three dotted lines. These lines indicate distribution boundaries. From west to east, each shows the Wallace plant line, the Wallace animal line, and the Weber line. Please take particular note of the relationship between these lines and the distribution pattern of each species. First, Papilio demulus occur from the Middle East to Malay and Australia, but until recently was not found in Borneo, Sulawesi, or the Philippines. However, since 1960, Papilio demulus has immigrated into these areas and also into the Caribbean nations. In addition, Inoue found this species on Guadalcanal Island in the Solomon Island group during his research in 2007. Prior to this, Papilio demulus had not been reported there. The major host plants of Papilio demulus are Strauss plant. We think Papilio demulus has expanded its range by taking passage on transport Strauss nursery plant. In the Philippines, the number of Papilio demulus individuals have increased in correspondence to the expansion of Strauss farms in the Philippines. Moreover, on the Nusa Tenggara Islands in Indonesia, original populations are thought to be mixed with populations from elsewhere. Next is Papilio demulium. The population from southern India is known as Papilio liomedon. In this presentation, we call these species the demulium group. The females of Malaysia, Sunda Islands, and southern India from this group produce egg towers when they lay their eggs. This behavior is quite unique among Papilio species. Susanta also showed additional early developmental stage in the formation of Papilio liomedon in 2005. When he described the final insta stage of this population as a sixth stage, this situation is also unique. In all other species, the final insta is the fifth stage. Third is Papilio paris. This distribution resembles to that of Papilio demulium. However, Papilio paris occurs in northern India, southern China, and Taiwan instead of the Philippines and Sulawesi. The race from southern India is very famous because of the extraordinary large body size compared to other races. The related species, Papilio carna, occurs on the Great Sunda Land and is partially overlapping with Papilio paris. Fourth Papilio Buddha and fifth Papilio Crino belong to the same Papilio pyrenulus group. The geographic distribution of this group also resembles that of Papilio demulium. However, it does not occur on the Indochina Peninsula or in Java. This group also does not occur in northern India, and this respect has a similar distribution as Papilio demulium, where Papilio paris occurs. Thus, the southern Indian populations are quite separated from other Papilio pyrenulus races. Sixth is Papilio castor group. Although the distribution of this group in the Asian continent resembles that of Papilio paris, this group does not occur on the Great Sunda Islands. A race found in southern India is known as Papilio drapidarium. Seventh is Papilio helenus. Papilio helenus occurs almost across all Southeast Asian regions continuously. Japan is also part of its distribution area. The color pattern of the last insta larva of Papilio helenus is also interesting. Except for Papilio macaon, Papilio species last insta larva have a saddle-like marking on their dorsal side abdomen. That of the race from main Japan is separated at the top of abdomen. In contrast, that of China is continuous. Our research, including review of available literature, indicates that those in Taiwan have separated markings, while those in the Philippines, Sulawesi, Java, and Northern Indochina have continuous markings. Our current study shows that those Southern India have continuous markings. Interesting question concerns: when, why, and how these different markings have evolved. Resembling Papilio paris, two related species, Papilio isuara and Papilio isuaroides walk on Great Sundaland with Papilio helenus. 8th, Papilio politus also occurs in almost all Southeast Asian regions. Moreover, this is one of the species for which the geographic distribution extends to Marco Island, located in an area east of the Weber Line. Papilio politus is well known by its mimic form, resembling the sympatric troidini species. The southern Indian race of Papilio politus are quite famous for their additional mimic form, resembling Paculiopta hector, that is endemic in southern India. The heredity of these forms were researched by Clark and Shepard in 1960s. They showed that Paculiopta hector form is the most dominant of these forms. They also showed that color pattern of interspecies hybridized females between Papilio politus and Papilio fuscus group species are also determined by the inheritance patterns of simple Mendelian trait. In 2014, Kunte and his co-workers reported analysis of the mimic system of this species using an integrative approach combining genetics and association mapping, transcriptome and genome sequencing, and gene expression analysis in Nature. Additionally, Murga and his student reported on the feeding, growth, and reproductive behavior of Papilio politus on 5 different Lutace appellants in 2010. Last is the Papilio memnon group, including Papilio polymnestor. This species group also occurs in the Marco Islands, located east side of the Weber Line. Females of this species group member also have various mimic forms. However, the female Papilio polymnestor has only one form, that is the same as that of male. In contrast, Aishigeru A shows that hybrid males and females between Papilio memnon and Papilio polymnestor make their offspring continuously. He thought these two species are nearest among Papilio memnon group instead of their appearance. Resembling Papilio paris and Papilio helenus, one related species group containing Papilio lampadax, Papilio fulvesi, and Papilio acheron occurs on Great Sundaland with Papilio memnon. Among these species, the last instalable of Papilio demoraeus, Papilio liometon, Papilio buddha, Papilio politus, and Papilio polymnestor are already well known. Recently, those of Papilio paris in southern India has also been illustrated. We also found that details of some Indian butterfly larva have been reported on the website. According to this, the saddle-like marking of some South Indian Papilio helenus distinguishes the left and right half of their dorsal side. This indicates that there is individual variation in this morphology. Above, we have provided a brief introduction into the international geographic distributions and diversity of nine Papilio species occurring in southern India. With the exception of Papilio demoraeus, all others are distributed to almost all regions of Southeast Asia. Many other animals also exhibit similar distribution patterns, suggesting that the distribution pattern must be determined by some common limitation of the environment. It is notable that in view of this some Papilio genus species show continuous distributions, while others show disjunct distributions. Final mention should be made of one more species, Papilio neferus. This species also occurs in Southeast Asia, but it does not occur in southern India. Difference in the geographical location of species must be affected by the characteristics of each species. We have tried to reveal these characteristics in our research.